Namaskar. In this lesson, we are going to study about the special purpose regions. Balanced development of different parts of the country, extension of the benefits of economic progress to the less developed regions, and widespread diffusion of industry are among the major aims of planned development. Successive 5-year plans seek to realize these aims in larger measure. Expansion of the economy and more rapid growth increase progressively the capacity to achieve a better balance between national and regional development. The defining of a region is for the purpose of preparing a development policy document which would help to raise the living standards of the people socially, physically, and economically. The people are the settlements of rural or urban. Hence, what aspects would lead to development and consequent upgradation in the living standards of the people in these settlements have to be identified at this stage. Special purpose regions are the regions which needs special development strategies which leads to the improvement of the area in terms of economic, physical, and social. Special purpose areas will develop as unique destinations of city and regional significance. Next is aims in formulating special purpose regions. Increase in national income and more balanced development of different parts of the country are thus related to one another, and step by step it becomes possible to create conditions in which resources in terms of natural endowment, skill and capital in each region are fully utilized. Sometimes the sense of lagging behind in development may be due not so much to a slower rate of overall growth in the region as to inadequate or tardy development in specific fields such as agriculture, irrigation, power or industry, employment. In each region, the nature of the problem and the impediments to rapid development in particular fields should be carefully studied and appropriate measures devised for accelerated development. The essential object should be to secure the fullest possible utilization of the resources of each region so that it can contribute to best to the national pool and take its due share from the benefits occurring from national development. The growth potential of each region should be fully developed, but the precise manner in which this goal is achieved and the stages of growth will not be identical. Some regional factors such as those connected with physical features and geographical location cannot be easily altered, but there are others which can be influenced by rising levels of education and skill, developing power, and generally by applying science and technology on a larger scale. Not all regions can offer equally favorable conditions for the development of industry. There are many examples both of countries and of regions within a country in which with limited development in industry, an appreciable rise in living standards has been achieved through the fuller utilization of local, natural and human resources. There are also instances of areas around massive projects where no great impact on the levels of living of the people is to be observed. Apart from the basic and capital goods, industries and other large industries, there are other industries whose possibilities need to be fully explored, such as labor intensive industries of the traditional type, small scale industries of the modern type, agricultural processing industries, forest industries, assembling operations and recreational industries. Each region should endeavor to identify, plan for and promote industries which are specially suited to its conditions and for which it can provide relatively greater facilities. Next is special area programs. Some state governments have also made allocations in the 6th plan for accelerated development of certain identified special areas. Special area programs have been formulated to deal with special problems faced by certain areas arising out of their distinct geophysical structure and concomitant socio-economic development. Let us study the different programs for the development of few special regions. First is Common Area Development Regions. During the post-independence period, high priority was accorded to increase agricultural production and productivity for providing food security to the people, and as such, a number of irrigation projects were constructed. The gap between irrigation potential created and the irrigation potential utilized prompted the Irrigation Commission in 1972 to make specific recommendations for systemic and integrated development of commands of irrigation projects. Following this, a committee of ministers in 1973 suggested creation of a broad-based area development authority for every major irrigation project to undertake the work of comprehensive area development and management. On the basis of the recommendations of the Committee of Ministers, Government of India launched a centrally sponsored scheme of Common Area Development Program in 1974 and 75. The primary objective of Common Area Development Program has been to bridge the gap between the irrigation potential created and that utilized through increase in irrigated areas and thereon to increase efficient utilization of irrigation water and improve the agricultural productivity in the irrigation commands. The program envisaged an integrated and coordinated approach to the development and management of command areas. Next is desert regions. To check desertification, projects are developed which facilitate development of productivity and productive resources of the area and its inhabitants. The Desert Development Program, it is also called as DDP, was started both in hot desert areas of Rajasthan, Gujarat and Haryana, and the cold deserts of Jammu and Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh in 1977 and 78. From 1995 and 96, the coverage has been extended to a few more districts in Andhra Pradesh and Karnataka. In hot sandy desert areas, sand dune stabilization and shelter belt plantations were given greater weightage. On the other hand, in cold desert areas, since rainfall is negligible, crop cultivation and afforestation were taken up only through assured irrigation. In these areas, the main activity was water resources development by construction of channels for diversion of water flow from glaciers and springs to the field and lift irrigation works in the valleys. The Desert Development Program was in operation in 131 blocks of 21 districts in 5 states up to 1994 and 95. On the recommendations of the Hanumant Rao Committee, 32 new blocks were brought within the preview of the program and 64 blocks were transferred from DPAP. Consequently, coverage of the program was extended to 227 blocks of the country with effect from January 1995. With the recognition of districts and blocks, the program is under implementation in 235 blocks of 40 districts in 7 states. The states where DDP is under implementation are Andhra Pradesh, Gujarat, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jammu and Kashmir, Karnataka and Rajasthan. Next is drought prone regions. To minimize the adverse effects of drought on the production of crops, livestock and productivity of land, water and human resources with drought proofing techniques. To promote the over-economic development and improve the socio-economic conditions of vulnerable groups. In order to combat the frequent recurrence of drought in the states, drought-prone area program, that is DPAP, was introduced during the year 1975. The drought-prone area program concentrated on non-arable lands. drainage lines for in-situ soil and moisture conservation, agroforestry, pasture development, horticulture and alternate land use were its main components. The program was first launched during 1973 and 74 to address special problems of drought prone areas. The program has been under implementation on watershed basis since 1995. The allocation for the program is shared in the ratio of 75:25 between the center and the state. Next is tribal region. A detailed and comprehensive review of the tribal people problem was taken up on the eve of the 5th 5-year plan period. The main objective is socio-economic development of tribal communities through income generating schemes allied with infrastructure development programs and protection of the tribal communities against exploitation. To achieve this integrated tribal development, agency came into existence. The ITDA project areas are generally contiguous areas of the size of a tehsil or block or more in which the ST population is 50% or more of the total. Due to the demographic profile of the tribal people in these regions, however, the ITDPs in Assam, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, West Bengal may be smaller or not contiguous. Andhra Pradesh and Orissa have opted for an agency model under the Registration of Societies Act, and ITDPs there are known as ITD agencies, that is ITDAs. So far, 194 ITDPs or ITDAs have been delineated in the country. In Jammu and Kashmir, though no ITDP has been delineated yet, the areas having ST population in the state are treated as covered under TSP strategy. In 8 states having scheduled areas, the ITDPs or ITDAs are generally coterminous with TSP areas. The ITDPs or ITDAs are headed by project officers, though they may be designated project administrators or project directors. The most significant contribution of tribal subplan in Barmer region is the development of infrastructure in terms of schools, healthcare facilities, potable water, roads, communications and electricity. Tremendous increase in literacy rate is observed. The female literacy rate in the region increased from 1.88% in 1971 to 42.83% in 2001. Improvement in sex ratio is observed and decline in the child marriage. The difference between males and females in literacy level, that is gender inequality, has also declined. The cultivation of pulses and other cash crops has increased in Barmer region. Next is backward areas or states. The areas for which the provision has been made are indicated, that is Gujarat. 25 backward taluks have been identified by the state government and a special provision of rupees 2 lakhs annually is envisaged for each taluk, that is rupees 50 lakhs annually for 25 taluks. In Jammu and Kashmir, the provision has been made for Leh and Kargil areas in Ladakh. Outlay also includes provision for beneficiary oriented programs for nomadic tribes in the states of Gujaras and Bakarwalas. In Kerala, their area number of regions in the state which have been considered as backward economically and socially. They include areas like Kasaragodu and Kannanur districts, Wayanad in Kozhikode districts and areas in Malappuram and Idukki districts. In Meghalaya, the outlay is for border areas regarded as special areas for purpose of accelerated development. In West Bengal, the outlay is meant for the following backward regions in the state, that is hilly areas, North Bengal, Jhelum and Sundarbans. Next is wasteland regions. Watershed is defined as a hydrogeologically unit of area from which the rainwater drains through a single outlet. Watershed development refers to the conservation, regeneration, and judicious use of all the natural resources like land, water, plants, and animals by human beings. Watershed management brings about the best possible balance between natural resources on the one side and human beings on the other. Human beings and the ecology are interdependent. The changes in the environment directly affect the lives of people depending on it. A degraded environment means a degraded quality of life of the people. This degradation can be tackled effectively through the holistic development of watershed. A watershed provides a natural geohydrological unit for planning any development initiative. The approach would be treatment from ridge to valley. Integrated Wasteland Development Program, that is IWDP, was introduced during 1992 with 100% central assistance. The Integrated Wasteland Development Program made afforestation and soil and moisture conservation in wastelands under government or community or private control as its predominant activity, without much focus on saturation of complete micro watershed and participation of people. The programs of dry land development in Andhra Pradesh have undergone a major change from 1995 and 96 with the introduction of new watershed guidelines. Common basic objective is land and water resource management for sustainable production. The term Watershed Plus emerged in 1998 to adopt new approaches in watershed projects that would step behind the usual boundaries in order to address the needs of marginalized groups of people, such as those with no land, women, and the poorest of the community. Next is Hill Areas and Northeastern Council. Hill Areas Development Program, that is HADP, has been in operation since the inception of the 5th 5-year plan and is being implemented for the integrated development of designated hill areas. The main objective of this program is to ensure ecologically sustainable socio-economic development of hill areas, keeping in view the basic needs of the people of hill areas. The designated hill areas covered under HADP were identified in 1965 by a committee of the National Development Council, that is NDC. These included 12 districts of Uttar Pradesh. However, consequent on the formation of Uttaranchal as a separate state, HADP is no longer in operation in the hill districts of erstwhile of Uttar Pradesh. Presently, the designated hill areas covered under HADP include hill districts of Assam, major parts of Darjeeling district of West Bengal, Nilgiris districts of Tamil Nadu. The main objectives of the program will continue to be eco-preservation and eco-restoration. However, the needs of the people, particularly their economic needs, have to be met if the ecosystem has to be preserved. Therefore, ecology and economy of the area have to be developed. The Special Central Assistance, that is SCA, provided for HADP is additive to normal state plan funds and supplements the efforts of the state governments towards accelerating the development of hill areas. This SCA is not meant to be utilized for normal state plan activities. The schemes under the HADP are to be properly dovetailed and integrated with the state plan schemes. The schemes undertaken under both these programs also need to be conceived and designed to achieve the specific objectives of this program and should not be merely conventional state plan schemes. Next is Western Ghats. Western Ghats Development Program, that is WGDP, was launched in 1974 and 75 as a part of the program for the development of hill areas of the country. For delineation of the areas for coverage by WGDP, the criteria of elevation and contiguity with taluk was adopted. The program is being implemented in 159 taluks comprising of Western Ghats in 5 states. Example, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu and Goa. Next is border areas. Border area development program was started in the year 1986 and 87 for balanced development of border areas of the states bordering Pakistan, namely Jammu and Kashmir, Punjab, Gujarat and Rajasthan. During the 8th plan, the program was revamped and its coverage was extended to the states on the eastern border with Bangladesh. In the 9th plan period, the program has been extended to all the land borders in response to the demands of the state governments and the Ministry of Home Affairs. Thus, in 1997 and 98, BADP was extended to states bordering Myanmar. In 1998 and 99, the states bordering China were included under the program, and from 1999-2000, the program was further extended to include the states bordering Nepal and Bhutan also. The main objective of BADP is to meet the special needs of the people living in remote and inaccessible areas situated near the border. This is a 100% centrally funded program, and Special Central Assistance (SCA) is provided for execution of approved schemes. The block is the basic unit for the program. The schemes to be taken up under the program are prepared by the concerned departments in the state and submitted to the nodal departments for approval by state level screening committee. The empowered committee at the central level deals with the policy matters relating to the scope of the program. Prescription of the geographical limits of the areas in the states and allocation of funds to the states. The schemes being selected by the state governments under the program are generally from sectors such as education, health, roads and bridges, water supply, etc. Particular emphasis is being given to improvement and strengthening of social and physical infrastructure. For this, the felt needs of the people are the prime criteria. Some of the state governments are undertaking construction of playgrounds, community halls, etc. so that the people, particularly unemployed youth, can spend their leisure time in constructive and creative activities. Next is KBK districts. The KBK region comprises of the original Kalahandi, Bulangir and Koraput districts situated in the southern and western part of Orissa. These three districts have been reorganized since 1992 and 93 into 8 districts, namely Kalahandi, Naupada, Bulangir, Sonepur, Koraput, Nabarangpur, Malakangiri and Rayaganda, comprising of 80 blocks, 1171 gram panchayats and 12,104 villages. This area has become the center of attention owing to the high levels of poverty and consequent adverse effects on the quality of the life of the people of this region. The plan consists of a central plan and centrally sponsored schemes in various sectors, namely agriculture, horticulture, watershed developed, afforestation, irrigation, health, drinking water, emergency feeding, welfare of SCs and STs, and rural connectivity. In order to fill critical gaps, additional central assistance of ₹243.95 crore was allocated by Planning Commission from 1998 and 99 to 2001 and 2002 to the KBK districts. Next is coastal regions. Coastal regions are defined by the extent of territorial waters up to the high water mark. Generally, the world's coastal zones are long narrow features of mainland, islands and seas, forming the outer boundary of the coastal domain from 200 meter above sea level to 200 meter below sea level. Coastal zones include the entire continental shelf and occupy about 18% of the surface of the globe, supplying about 90% of the global fish catch and accounts for some 25% of global primary productivity, while at the same time being some of the most endangered regions on the planet. At the World Bank, Coastal Zone Management (CZM) is a part of Integrated Coastal Management (ICM), which is an interdisciplinary and intersectoral approach to problem definition and solutions in the coastal zone. It includes a range of initiatives that promote environmentally sustainable development of coastal areas and encompasses a range of activities such as community-based management of coastal resources, large-scale infrastructure development, that is ports, industries and residential parks, etc., pollution and erosion control, aquaculture, tourism and recreation, oil spill contingency planning and navigational risk assessment. CZM is a process of governance that consists of the legal and institutional framework necessary to ensure that development and management plans for coastal zones are integrated with environmental and social goals and are developed with the participation of those affected. The purpose of ICM is to maximize the benefits provided by the coastal zone and to minimize the conflicts and harmful effects of activities on social, cultural and environmental resources. Purpose of coastal zone management is to maximize the benefits provided by the coastal zone, minimize conflicts and harmful effects of activities upon each other, resources and the environment, promote linkages between sectoral activities, guide coastal area development in an ecologically sustainable fashion. For some, integrated coastal zone management protects habitats, that is wetlands, corals and their water quality, and also prevents the loss of life, while for others it provides a means of public access to coastal areas. Lastly, I conclude by saying that special purpose regions are the regions which need special development strategies, which leads to the improvement of the area in terms of economic, physical and social. Special purpose areas will develop as unique destinations of city and regional significance. The growth potential of each region should be fully developed, but the precise manner in which this goal is achieved and the stages of growth will not be identical. Some regional factors such as those connected with physical features and geographical location cannot be easily altered, but there are others which can be influenced by rising levels of education, skill, developing power, generally by applying science and technology on a larger scale. Large-scale industries, especially basic and heavy industries, frequently serve as spearhead of intensive and broad-based development. Thank you.